Hi everyone, welcome you all. So in the today's video, let us try to learn how to handle auto suggest drop down in Playwright. So first of all, let us see what is auto suggest drop down. So for that, I'm trying to use one application, redbus.in, and we can see an auto suggest drop down in this particular application. So if I look at here, there is two options, from, to, and date. So here, if you want to search for some location, let's say I'm searching for Delhi, something like this. Now, as soon as you provided some value in it, it will give you some suggestions. You can see some auto suggestions it will give you. Now, from this auto suggestions, I just want to select one of the option. Okay. So this is simple auto suggestion drop down. So we can select one of these options. And you may not see these options on the same order most of the times. So this order also will be changed. Okay, so dynamically the order of these options will be changed. So this is basically called as auto suggest drop down. Okay, now we'll see how to handle this in the Playwright. So for that, I have created one specification file under my test, auto suggest drop down.spec.js, and I have imported test and expert functions from the Playwright test model. Then I have created one test block. And inside this, I provided auto suggest drop down. This is the title of the test. Now, this is a page fixture. Now, here I'm launching my application, redbus.in. Now, so as soon as you launch your application, so first thing is what we need to provide some text or some value into the from field. Okay. So we need to inspect this element and then we can pass this value. So, for that, what I'll do is let us try to inspect this element. Auto suggest drop down, and let's take the help of selector hub. And if I look at this, this is a relative XPath which is provided for this particular element. And basically, SRC is an ID value. So instead of XPath, I'm trying to use directly CSS selector. ID means we can use hash SRC. So this will able to locate the element. Now, by using this locator, I can inspect that element. So simply what you can do is await page dot locator and specify the locator. This is basically an input box. So inside that box, we can pass the search text. So here I'm trying to fill, let's say Delhi. Okay. So now I have passed some value into the input box. So as soon as you provided this value, so it will give you some auto suggestions automatically. So you can see as soon as I provided some value here, it will give you some auto suggestions. So the next task is what we need to capture these options. Whatever auto suggestions are providing, we need to capture them into a variable. Then we have to repeat one by one, and whichever is matching, we have to select that option. Okay. So normally what happens is this type of drop downs, auto suggestion drop downs, whenever you are searching for something, it will take few seconds of time to get this information from the server. Okay, so as soon as you provided some value in the search box, we need to wait for some time to display these options. Okay, so for that, what I will do is I will write one locator or selector which will locate all these options, and then I will wait for these options are available. Okay, I will wait for these options should be displayed. So before that, let us try to write one locator which will able to match all these auto suggestions. Okay, so for that, what we need to do is we need to take the help of selector hub, and we can easily write the locator to capture these options. So if I inspect one of these options, let me inspect the first option, and this is a text element. Okay, and before that, there is one more text element. You can see this is actually Delhi. All are belongs to Delhi only, that we need to select the main option, right? So the first text element we have to capture. And this is part of the div tag again. This is again part of the li, and this li is a part of the ul. So basically this is a list box. Under user list, we can find multiple li's, okay? Now we need to write proper locator which will able to capture the values, locations from the Delhi, okay? So I'm going to write one locator. /li, I'm directly jumping into li, and this is basically an XPath I'm going to write li, and when I say li, 38 items are displayed. Now I want to filter every li is having some class attribute. You can see here SCIWSKBI, some class attribute is there. So I've just filtered those li's which are having same class attribute at the rate class. And what is the value of the classes? SCIWSKBI. So this is the class value. So again, class is having multiple things, right? So I'm using, I'm trying to use contains function here from the XPath. I can say contains, right? So contains of at the rate class, and this is the value we are expecting. So now 18 elements are exactly matching. Now inside this li, again, we need to go to div tag. Inside the div tag, actual text tag is present, right? So inside this, we need to continue this, comma, div tag slash text. So 34 elements are matching. But again, among 34, we don't need the second text actually. For every text value, you can say Delhi is commonly there. So that is actually the second text. The only first text we need. So I can pass some index number here like this. Now you can see this particular XPath is exactly pointing the options or auto suggestions from the dropdown. So now let me use this locator, and I will wait for all the options are displayed on the box. So in PlayWrite, we have a method called await page dot wait for selector. I'm calling one method called wait for selector. And here you can pass the selector, whatever we are specifying. So because this is an XPath, I can just put in the double quotations. So this particular command basically wait for all the options displayed on the web page. And after that, we need to start reading each and every individual option by writing a for loop. And the for loop, I can specify. And before writing the options, we need to capture the options, right? Here, we are just waiting for the options. So once the options are available, we need to capture them into a variable. So what I'll do is I will write await page dot locator. Here, we are getting multiple locator, multiple elements. So I can say dollar dollar. And inside this, I can just pass the same locator, whatever I mentioned above. So this actually, this locator is pointing with all the options which are displayed on this auto session box. Okay, now this is a locator. This will return all the options. And basically, they are from city options. I'm getting one variable. I'm creating one variable called from city options. From city options. Now I make this variable as const variable. Now I just want to read each and every option from this. So for that, I can use from city options, from the from city options. Each and every option I want to get in a variable, let's say option of. And this should be, you can say let. You can define one variable called let. So now from the from CD options, I'm reading each and every option into this option. Now from that option, we have to capture the text. So to capture the text, simply I can say await option dot text content. So this is the function we have to call. So this will exactly return the content, the value of that option that I'm going to store in a variable. And I can make this as a const variable. Okay, so before selecting the option out from the auto session, let's try to print the values. So for that, I'm saying console.log. And here, I'm just printing the value, whatever I'm capturing from the auto suggestion dropdown. All right. So after printing, I'm just wait for some time and then I close my page. Await page dot wait for timeout. So here I can just specify some 3000 milliseconds. So simply what I have done here is I just first fill the value in the dropdown. Basically that is having input box. So we have filled the data and it is showing all the auto suggestions. And I'm waiting for those auto suggestions. And once the auto suggestions are displayed, then I'm getting all the auto suggestions into variable. And then I'm reading each and every option into this option variable. And then capture the text content of that variable and put this in the value. And then I'm printing the values. Okay. Now let us try to execute this and see. And then after execution of this, then we will see how we can select that value. So go to terminal, take the new terminal, and I'm running this command. npx play rate test, under test tab, what is the file name? Auto suggest drop down. Auto suggest drop down. Auto suggest drop down spec.js. Okay, press enter. Now it is started executing my code. Just observe, it is provided Delhi and now it is giving some auto suggestions. And now we have to capture them and then we have to print in the console window. So if I just look at this, we got all the values printed in the console. So these are the, we provided Delhi. So we have provided, we got all the options displayed in the console. So now the next thing is in this options, we have to select one of the options. Let's say I want to select something called Anand Vihar. This is the option I want to select from the auto suggestion. So now what we can do is instead of just printing the value. Okay, so what I can do is I'm not going to print this. So we already captured the value, right? Now we need to put one if condition. So I can say if, so whatever value we captured, that value includes, if the value includes and this is the value, then what we should do, we should go and click on that option. So take this option, whatever we capture, and then perform the click. That's it. So we never use any command, we use await. So after clicking on the option, we don't need to go to the further option. So immediately break the loop. Okay. So simply we can do like this. So after completion of the time, so I can just wait for 5 seconds so that we can clearly see the option which is selected in the auto suggestion drop down. Okay. Now save the file and then clear and execute one more time. So now I have selected, I provided Delhi here. And inside the Delhi, there are multiple cities. So Anand Vihar, I'm going to select from that options. Now execute. Now just observe the from, you can see Anand Vihar is got selected. Okay. So this is how we can simply handle auto suggest drop down. So even though the auto suggestion options are dynamically changing, still the same logic works. So what we have done is we provided the search value and whatever auto suggestions are appeared, we are waiting for those auto suggestions. Then we capture all the suggestions and then we are reading each and every suggestion into variable and I capture the text content. And if the text content is equal to this one, then we go and click on that option and exit from the loop. So this is how we can simply handle auto suggest drop down in Playwright. Okay. So in the next video, I will show you how to handle hidden drop down. Okay. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. We'll see in the next video.